What's going on, gamers? Today, we're going to be going over OneBlock, how to install it on your server, how to play, and why it's super cool. Before we get into this tutorial, don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can stay up to date on every tutorial we upload, just like this one. While Minecraft is a game of what seems to be infinite possibilities, after a while the gameplay is just something you've done for a really long time and you want to spice it up a little bit. Well, today we're going to be going over OneBlock. There are tons of different game modes available to add new challenges to Minecraft. OneBlock is a very popular game mode that challenges your ability to manage your resources. Without some clever planning, your players may end up falling through the void or wasting invaluable resources. This game mode is super straightforward. Players spawn on one block, up in the air, and no other resources nearby. The only way they can get new materials is by breaking the block beneath them, and each time they break the block, a new one is going to replace it. New materials are added as they continue to break the regenerating block. Over time, they're going to gain enough items to start building their own base and farms. The end goal, if any, is completely up to you and your players to decide. And if you don't get how to play, OneBlock is a pretty easy concept to grasp. The goal is to build up your island using the limited materials that you're given. You start on a single grass block without any other items in your inventory. To gain new materials, you're going to have to break the block beneath you. Each time you break the block, a new one is going to replace it. And you are going to level up over time as you break more blocks. And as your level increases, you're going to gain access to new materials. Over time, players can start building huge bases and machines as they gain access to new materials, like in regular Minecraft, but resource management is going to be completely different at OneBlock. There's no caves to explore or villages to plunder, so you have to rely entirely on any farms that you make and the regenerating block. And now we're going to go over downloading the plugin. Again, another thing that's super, super easy. All you have to do is head over to the OneBlock spigot page. That, of course, is going to be linked in the description below this video. Then in the top right, click on the download button. You're going to receive a file called something like oneblock.jar. You can save this to your desktop or to a folder where it's easy to remember the location in the next step. Now that you've downloaded the mod, go ahead and hop onto your Apex server panel and stop your server. When you click on stop, this turns your server into the offline mode where you can then make changes to your server without worrying about it breaking, hopefully. Now we can scroll down to the game file section and make sure that we're on PaperMC and that we're on a version of Paper that's compatible with our server. This also works with Spigot, but we really recommend Paper for these servers because it just works. Now that you know you're on Paper or Spigot and your version of Minecraft is compatible with the plugin that you downloaded, you can click on FTP file access on the left-hand side of the screen. Log in with your information, and once you're logged in, scroll down and find the plugins folder. In the plugins folder, click on upload at the left of the screen and open up that folder where you downloaded OneBlock to earlier. Now get that jar file, click it, and drag it over to the right side of the page. Once the file's at 100% and it says uploaded 1 out of 1 files at the top of the page, then click on the name of your server at the top of the page and either start or restart your server to get it up and running. And once your server is online, you can hop into console on the left-hand side of the page by clicking on it, and then click on that text box on the console page. You can type in PL or /PL, whichever one works for you. It should just be PL, and hit enter. And this is gonna show all your plugins once your server is online. OneBlock has a ton of customization options, but if you want to just get straight into playing OneBlock, you can skip any extra configuration and go about creating an island for your players. To create a new OneBlock island, go to the location you want the game to start and run the command by typing /obset. This is going to cause a grass block to be placed at your location. This is the default first island that the plugin is going to use. New islands are going to be created automatically in a radius around the first one. Players can join the game by running the command /ob join. They are going to be teleported to the first available island, or a new one is going to be created for them automatically. Each player could reset their progress and start over by running the command /ob (I, D, R) reset. So /ob (ID, R) reset. /ob set (radius) replaces the radius with either 100 or 500. This tells the plugin how far away new islands should be from each other. So /ob set (500) will set each island 500 blocks away from the others. In /ob physics (true or false) is gonna set the physics to true or false depending on what you pick. So if you set it to true, sand is gonna fall and gravel is gonna fall to experience gravity. If you need a new challenge or you're just tired of getting tired of vanilla Minecraft, OneBlock is a great option for a new game mode. It's a fun and simple mini game that's easy to pick up for new players as well. It can add hundreds of hours to gameplay to any server, and it's great for players of any skill level. With the help of this guide and the OneBlock plugin, you're now ready to start building your own world from a single block. Well, folks, that's all we've got for you today. And as always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.